that are surrounding radicalization and issues in the coast of Kenya is mainly in historical injustices, because of the way the colonialists divided or came into Kenya, they did not get much of the education per se, and therefore most of the job opportunities have been taken up by people that are not natives of the area, and therefore they feel like they're discriminated. So because of little information or because of little education, you realize majority of them are unemployed. And those that are unemployed are mainly the youth, because they're the ones that are in the community, and because they're unemployed, they become a target for the recruiters, because they're promised jobs and they're promised incomes, and therefore, because of that discrimination, they become a little bit prone to being radicalized or to being recruited into some militia kind of movements. Secondly, because of religion, basically when we look at the historical trends on missionaries, mainly it was more of an Islamic kind of a region, and you find they have some differences. And then the doctrines, the religious teachings again, are bringing some controversies, and in the process they become a little bit prone. The majority of the people tend to be divided, and mainly so because of the religions. So it is one of the other causes as to why people become recruited. When you talk about the Islamic religion per se, they have an item, or rather a teaching, where they call jihad. And it's like it has not been very well stipulated as to what really jihad is. And therefore, when they are told that they're defending religion, it's more affecting the Muslims than Christians, because the Christian doctrines do not talk about any jihad of some sort. And majority residents in the coast region have been more of Muslims than Christians. And that's why most youth have been taken in, being recruited into militia groups. Parents and religious leaders can play a role in trying to educate, trying to give the right virtues, especially the parents, trying to do the, to give the children the right teachings, and trying to mold them as into what is acceptable, the norms in the society. And once they already know what is right for them, then they will become resistant to being recruited or being promised things that they are not very sure about. So educators and parents would play a major role in trying to teach them on what is good and morals of the society. And by so doing, they will be strong to resist any promises, unless it is something that is tangible, that they know this is a job that is being promised. They would want to query more as into what kind of a job it is, rather than being told that you'll be given money or you'll be taken for trainings, and they don't know what kind of trainings those are. The role of women generally in CVE will be actually more so in parenting and also educating. You realize a child, most of the time, the mothers have more time to spend with the children, because when they give birth to the children, right from the initial days, right from the beginning of the life of a child, the mother is there with the child through breastfeeding, training them on how to talk. When the mother are conscious about the kind of youth that they need in the community, they have an opportunity to train them to be able to do what is good. So the role of the women is very critical when it comes to parenting and instilling good morals onto the children.